MLB Network's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Today, a spring training matchup between the Minnesota Twins and the Pittsburgh Pirates. Number 13 makes his big league debut right after this. Number 39, the Delaware-born hurler, gets the call to start here. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, we're going to get a chance to look at a guy that is a little bit up and down throughout points of his career. A career ERA just over 4. When he's good, he can be really good. And when he's bad, well, let's just say he can be pretty bad at times. But it'll be interesting to see which one we see. He's a little bit of Jekyll and Hyde. Hopefully he's going to be a little bit more Jekyll than Hyde in this one here today.
Line drive to left. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. So the leadoff man reaches base to start out the first.
Boy, that's not a bad pitch right there. That's a pretty good sinker. He just happens to hook that one right into left field for a base hit.
Yeah, he got the bat head out right there, Dan, and was able to get that one to left field.
Into the box, Luis Arias. Checks his swing, but this will be strike two call. Hit on the ground out to short. A dive, but he can't knock it down. It's through for a base hit.
Hey, two runners on after back-to-back singles right there. They are in prime position to put the first run on the board right here.
At the plate now, Nelson Cruz grounded back up the middle. One there, relay to first, and that'll take care of Cruz. It's a double play. Coming to the plate now, Miguel Sano. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. The 1-2 pitch. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. One left for Minnesota. Now the Pirates will get their first opportunity. No score. Kenta Maeda, the right-hander from Japan, will get the starting assignment in this one. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Well, this guy's kind of unique. How about a 5-pitch repertoire that he has? That gives him a lot of options for both righties and lefties. And if he's on, he could be really tough to hit.
Digging in now, Kevin Newman. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. 1-1. Is a curveball taken low for a ball. And now here's a ball hit pretty well out toward right center field. There to take it is Cruz, and that's the first out. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring up Anthony Alford. That softly hit to right. Will that get down? Yes, it will. He's got himself a one-out single.
That's what you want the guys at the top of the order to do. Set the table for the Monsters 3-4-5. Nice piece of hitting.
Stepping in now, Ryan Reynolds. Strike two as the fastball is let go. And there are our umpires calling balls and strikes is Mr. Ed Drummond.
Yeah, Matty. Hey, you know what, D-Row? This Ed Drummond, he's a good umpire. Fair umpire, good ball and strike umpire. Pretty much straight down the road.
That's all you look for, Dan. Just be consistent. I don't care if you're given 2 to 3 inches off the outside corner, but you can't do it on the inside corner. If you're going to stick to one thing and stay consistent with it, no player will have a gripe with you.
Next to bat will be the Pittsburgh cleanup batter, Colin Moran. Opportunity for him here to pick up that runner from second with two away. A 1-2 pitch. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. One left for Pittsburgh. Still no score. All set for the start of the inning, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Max Kepler. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Not fooled there as this ball's hammered out to deep right field. Polanco looking up. Gone to lead off the inning. A solo shot here to straightaway right field as the Twins take a 1-0 lead.
Well, if you're going to give up a towering blast to one of the best players in their lineup, it's better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be the deciding factor in a game.
The next twin up, Josh Donaldson. No outs, nobody on. Hit the other way out toward right field. Polanco has a read on it, one down. So that'll bring in Byron Buxton. One run in and one gone so far this inning. Bases are empty, one man out. Fouled away. Good hard sinker, but he lays off to even things at 2-2.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
Three balls and two strikes to the Twins center fielder. And opposite field as he lines this down the line in right. And that is down as that could be two bases. And he'll reach second now with one away.
When it left his bat, I thought it might squirt foul, but it hugged the line and found its way into the corner. Thought it might be a little bit closer play at second, but he cruised in there with relative ease.
At the plate, Mitch Garver. 1-2 to the Twins catcher.
You chase a pitch that bad outside the zone, you got to find a way to regroup, adjust the batting gloves, only look over the hard those 17 inches.
Oh, they think they may have gotten him again. This one's hit deep to left field, and for the second time in the inning, the gopher ball will come back to bite him. It's a home run. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left as the Twins have made it a 3-0 ball game. That one just kept going and going. You won't see many long balls hit farther than that this season, and as ShowTrack tells us, it carried a projected 460 feet. That's big boy territory. Standing in now, Kenta Maeda. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Well, I think he just kind of lost focus on the mound right there. It's clearly not going his way, and he's thinking more about that than the task at hand. And right now, he needs to think about this hitter.
Now the 2-1 pitch. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. In comes Alford. And he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out. Digging in for his second at bat, Andrelton Simmons. He reached on a single in his first try. Now the 3-2 pitch is swung on and missed, strike three. So two home runs in the inning lead to three runs on the scoreboard. On now to the bottom of the second. Twins lead it 3-0. Up next for the Buccos, Ke'Bryan Hayes. And this at-bat marks the beginning of his big league career. An exciting moment for him.
You know, Matty, the talent's undeniable with this guy. High round draft pick, but nothing's given once you get to this point. A lot of people are super excited to see if he could be one of the faces of the future of this organization.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
Here's Gregory Polanco. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. Here it comes on 1-1. Keeping it down here as it's to 1-2.
Good thing he didn't make contact with that pitch. Only thing he could do is probably hit that on the ground. It could be a double play ball.
The 1-2. And this is foul tipped as he stays alive here. But meanwhile, that ball came right back at our home plate umpire, and he may need some attention at this moment. To two balls and two strikes now. Fouled off. Now a fastball inside, and he works it back to a full count now.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitch.
And he gets around on one and hits it high and deep to straightaway right. And, oh, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Boy, Dero, that looked like extra bases right off the bat. This thing caroms off the wall. Outfielder does a great job of getting it in quickly and probably does a good job holding him to a single.
Yeah, I'm surprised he's not standing on second base there, but you run the replay back. He was busting it out of the box. It's just a nice job by the defense to hold him to a single.
Hey, time to start making some quality pitches. He finds himself in a tough spot behind an account with guys on base.
Nope. 3-1 now as that misses down and in.
I love the approach out on the mound. Everything's down in the zone as it should be, but now you find yourself in a 3-1 count. Do you elevate a little bit more and get back in this zone, or do you just pitch around them?
Oh, you had him fooled there. It's 3-2 now. Hayes on second. Polanco on at first with nobody out. Smoked on the ground up the middle. Simmons on to first, and they get them both.
Oh, that's a rally killer right there. They were in great shape with two on and nobody out. But the double play is the last thing you want in that situation. Just a runner at third now, but there's two outs.
Jacob Stallings will be the next hitter, trying to cash in here in his first at-bat with a runner at third and two gone. The 1-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
Threw that fastball right by him. He had no chance to get the barrel to that one.
Hit back up the middle. Simmons has it. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. Pirates leave one. Still down 3-0. Stepping up now, Luis Arraez. He singled his last time up.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
Late on that one as it's foul off to the left side. The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him.
For me, check swings are right there next to bang-bang plays at first as the most difficult calls for an ump to make. Taking a look at show motion, the batter doesn't appear to hold up enough, so I think the call was right.
And this one runs a little too far in, ball two.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
3-1. Miguel Sano will be next. One out, nobody on. Now a drive by Cruz. Deep left field. Gone! A solo home run from Nelson Cruz as the Twins are looking good here, up 4-0.
Wow, nothing more demoralizing than giving up 3 home runs in the first 3 innings of a game. There's having a guy's number, and then there's absolutely owning him. This could be the latter.
In now, Miguel Sano to 2-2 now. Into the corner and slicing foul. Bases are empty, one man out. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Reynolds is underneath this one. And there's the second out of the inning. Up next for Minnesota, Max Kepler. He got a hold of one and went yard in his first appearance in this one.
It'll be interesting to see if they use that changeup in this at-bat. That last at-bat, that was a changeup he hit for a home run. I'm going to see if this time they don't go to more fastballs and curveballs.
Line down the left field line. But this is going to get foul. Another 1-2 delivery. Bouncer to the left side. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. But the Twins add on thanks to this solo shot. We played 2.5, and the Twins have taken a 4-0 lead. So here now is the pitcher, number 39, ready to get his day at the plate started right here. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Now here's the pitch. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Well, you know, AL pitchers must love pitching in NL ballparks because all of a sudden they're only facing 8 legitimate hitters in the lineup instead of 9. Kind of makes you wonder why any free agent pitcher would ever decide to pitch in the AL, doesn't it?
Into the box, Kevin Newman. And this misses for ball 4. The second walk he surrendered here in the first 3 innings. So the next to the plate for Pittsburgh, Anthony Alford. 1-for-1 after a single his first time up. Runners on first with 1 down. Ball and 2 strikes.
1-2.
fouls this one off. Lays off, 2-2 now. Fly ball right down the line and left. Kepler's on his horse, and they can't run it down. 2-2 one more time, and it's fouled away. Breaking ball, that's in the dirt as he takes a ball.
I don't even think I need to look in the dugout on this one. I think it's safe to assume he's going to be running. Too good a hitter at the plate not to think he's going to put the ball in play.
Now a throw over, and he'll dive back in. Fouled away. Runners off for second, but he won't draw a throw. That's taken for ball four, and it's first and second now with one away.
And that's two free passes in the third inning alone, so you have to wonder if maybe it's something mechanical or if it's just psychological. Got to get back on track here.
Stepping up to the plate, Brian Reynolds, 0 for 1 here in the early going. And he misses, 2-1.
Hey, lots of guys get too aggressive in a spot like this, but he's done a nice job of gaining some count leverage. Look for him to put the ball in play hard.
And he jumps at a changeup, a swing and a miss. Here now, the 2-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Runners are at first and second with one away. And that misses. Ball four, and he's going to need to settle down in a hurry now because he's in a peck of trouble.
And I'm pretty sure he thought that was a strike. He's thinking, what do I have to do? Put a bow on it? Walk it down and put it in the catcher's glove by myself? I think it got called a little outside, so he has to put it behind him now.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Colin Moran. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
And he can't allow the same thing to happen in this situation. This is a big-time spot in this game. He's got to find a way to put the ball in play.
Has to challenge him now. Here's the pitch. Ground ball to second. This could be two. To second for one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. Just what the doctor ordered. He gets the double play to get him out of the inning. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Mitch Keller will come out now and make his first appearance of the spring. Josh Donaldson digging in now. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Now the 2-1 pitch. Grounder down the line at third, but this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Now here's the pitch.
Count is ball, 3-2.
Fouled off. another full count pitch home. Popped him up. Stallings is under it, and that's the first out of the inning. Trying to pick things up where we left off, Byron Buxton. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at-bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game, which is his speed. But with the strikeout right there, you can't get on first base if you strike out.
Into the box now, Mitch Garver. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Four runs, six hits, and no errors in the ballgame for Minnesota. Fastball too low, and that's ball four.
That's a nice job to work that walk right there. Even if it doesn't lead to anything on the scoreboard this inning, it prevents the pitcher from having to lead off of the next one. Just one of those small things that might go unnoticed, but in the end, make a big difference.
So the runner at first here with two gone in the inning, and that brings up the pitcher, Kenta Maeda. The 1-1. A bouncer up the middle. Newman fields it cleanly. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Twins wind up stranding one, but they're in front 4-0. Jose Berríos, a right-hander standing 6 foot even, will take over the pitching duties here. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And set to go is the third baseman, Key Brian Hayes. Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Well, at the plate, he kind of got bailed out on that previous pitch. I think it should have been a strike. Then he goes down looking, and you really can't feel too sorry for him. Not a lot of protecting with two strikes there.
So now to the plate, Gregory Polanco. To two balls and two strikes now.
In today's game, everybody's trying to work off the mound north-south, trying to elevate that heater. He wanted that pitch right there, but I can tell you as an offensive player, I'd rather give you 6 inches off east-west than to have you call that high fastball.
3-2, full count. One out, nobody on. Lined hard toward right center. Buxton will range to his left and put it away. Two down. So here's Adam Frazier. The 1-1. Two out, nobody on. Two and two to Adam Frazier. And he'll hang in here as he reaches to foul this one away. Still even at 2-2. Fastball called, strike three, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Pirates. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. Will Crow, a 6'2" right-hander, jogs in to take over on the mound. Now in the box, Andrelton Simmons. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. Hit to short. Newman brings it in. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. At the plate, Luis Arraez, a hit in two tries so far. Four runs, six hits, and no errors in the ballgame for Minnesota. Slider clocked in the mid-80s there. It's a ball and two strikes. The 1-2. Lifted down the line in left. Long run for the left fielder, and they can't run it down. He'll try again, 1-2. Bases are empty, one man out. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
Don't be surprised if he gets another back foot slider right here. Don't think for a second, just because he took the first one, that this pitcher won't come back exactly the same way.
2-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him.
Well, you gotta love a live young arm. He's got an electric fastball. And if he can learn to harness that and work in his solid secondary stuff, he's going to have a really nice career on the mound. Not everyone is gifted with a fastball like that.
Stepping in now, Nelson Cruz. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Sitting in a good spot right here. Two ball, one strike count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters' counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
And this one misses inside a ball he walked him, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Miguel Sano, 0-2 on his line thus far. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit hard on the ground towards second. And that's through for his first base hit in this one.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, and ripped the base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes even when you make a good pitch, the ball's going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
At the plate now, Max Kepler. Ground ball sent back up the middle. He's got it. On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and two men left on. Home half of the fifth coming up. Minnesota leads this one 4-0. Michael Pineda, the tall right-handed reliever, takes over pitching duties out of the bullpen now. Into the box now, Jacob Stallings. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. The 1-1. Hey. Some movement now in the Minnesota bullpen as a right-hander's up and throwing. Hit back toward the mound. And that'll get on by into center field for a leadoff single.
He had him on the ropes right there. Count leverage, two strikes against the batter. He's going to have to put that into memory bank because that guy made a nice two-strike approach right there, made a nice two-strike adjustment.
To the plate now, Will Crow. And a bunt attempt misses, so he's behind now, 1-2.
He's going to be looking down at the third base coach right now, hoping he takes this bunt sign off. It's just a lost art in today's game.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. Bit of a surprise here as he's going to try to lay one down. Simmons, throw on to first, won't be in time, so they just get the one there.
Took a pretty long time for the shortstop to receive the ball that time. So that gave the runner plenty of time to bear down on him and take him out. Hopefully everyone's okay down there.
So the Pirates batting order turns over and set to go. Kevin Newman, it was a walk in his last trip. 1-1, here it comes. Runner at first here, one man out. Just a bit low, tough call, but it's 2-2. From the stretch. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count, you send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Now the payoff pitch home. And he misses with that one for ball four. So that'll put runners on first and second now with one away. Stepping in, Anthony Alford. It was a walk in his last trip. And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now.
Wow, that's awfully impressive right there. The pitch before was really close. Called the ball. What does he do? He comes back with a better pitch and gets the punch out.
In now, Brian Reynolds. Not where you want the changeup, but he gets away with it for a strike.
Can't say he's tickling around the zone. Those last two pitches were pretty much grooved right down the middle, but it didn't bite him.
Pineda pauses. Here's his offering. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And this is going to get down for extra bases, as that'll get one, if not both of them, home. And the second run is in as well, as they're on the board in a big way. It's 4-2 now.
This thing was a double or more the second it left his bat. He really drove it well, and it ended up one hopping the wall out there. And more importantly, he picks up two RBI along the way.
Into the box now, Colin Moran. And oh, that looked to catch him flush down near the foot or the ankle. He's safe. A great recovery, but he couldn't get it there in time. And with that play over now, time to check and see if our man is all right. You can really see him favoring that leg. And that is his plant leg, which is always a concern. But from the way he's acting out there, I think it looks like he's going to be okay to try and continue. At the plate, Key Brian Hayes. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now. And he lays off the pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
Boy, this has been a different guy in the fifth inning. First four innings on cruise control. Fifth inning, nothing seems to be able to work. He needs to find that focus back.
Another try at 2-2. Lined hard toward right center. Base hit, and that'll get a run in. Joan Duran trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away.
Oh,
Standing in, Gregory Polanco. Three across so far in the inning and another two out there on base.
Yeah, Matt, and this inning's really starting to get away from them on the defensive side of the ball. Stranding the rest of those guys out here feels absolutely essential for them at this point.
And he misses ball four, so he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces.
Well, he's a youngster. You can see he's a little nervous out there. Some people call it butterflies, but to him it probably feels like pterodactyls are flying around in his gut. Going to be interesting to see if he can settle down here.
So stepping in, Adam Frazier, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Popped him up. Simmons has a play. He's got it to end the inning as they'll strand the tying run in scoring position. So they do get three that inning. That's the good news. The bad news is they leave three men on base. We're through five here at the ballpark. It's the Twins four and the Pirates three. Sean Poppin takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. Here's the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. Now the 3-2 pitch. Little chopper back to the mound. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. At the plate, Byron Buxton. Hot shot down the line, but this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. And that's going to be high, 2-2 now.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
Now here it comes. And he just misses inside with the fastball there.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
And he takes ball four, so he's on. And as you know, that often means the steal could be in order here.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Mitch Garver will dig in again, and as he does, we'll flash you back to inning number two as you get a look at his two-run homer that was a big blow early on. Runners on first with one down. There goes Buxton. In there, now the throw. Way late, and he's in there easily at second.
This catcher has an elite arm, but when you get that great of a jump at first base, it makes it a lot easier to steal second.
Now a spin and a throw back to second, and he just manages to get his hand in. 4-3 our score here as we play inning number six. Fly ball out toward left center field. And he can't track it down. A base hit. They're going to extend their lead as the runner scores from second.
Boy, this guy's having a great game here so far, D-Row. Home run earlier in the night, and that base hit right there drives in his third run batted in of this game.
Yeah, you drive to the park every day hoping your rhythm and timing is on point with that pitcher's windup. And that's exactly been the case today. He not only mixed in that big bomb, but now he's got three ribbies to boot.
And he's a little too high with that one. Two balls and a strike. No. off the outside that time as the breaking ball can't catch the zone. Waiting next is Andrelton Simmons. Runner at first here, one man out. And he takes a cold strike at the knees, and that'll run things full.
I think it's a real possibility that they put that runner in first in motion. That would help them stay out of that double play that would end the inning, but that's also kind of risky at the same time.
The 3-2 pitch. And he lays off ball four, so he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done.
Right about now, the manager's questioning his decision to bring this guy in. If you can't trust a reliever to throw strikes, you can't trust him at all. We'll see if he comes to get him sooner than later.
So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out. And standing in, one of the best two-strike hitters in baseball, Andrelton Simmons. Now both runners on the move. Offered at and missed. Here's the throw. It's there in plenty of time. He's out trying to steal third as they get the lead runner here. Outside and a full count, 3-2.
I'll tell you, it's a helpless feeling for a manager or a pitching coach when your pitchers are having a really hard time throwing strikes. What are you supposed to do other than keep trying new guys until someone starts attacking the zone?
And this is pop foul, but perhaps playable behind first. And he lays out, but he can't make the play. We'll do it again. He's set. Here's the 3-2. This is line to left, and that's in there. Base hit. Not in time as the run scores. The throw, and he's tagged out at second. That'll end the inning, but they do score one on the play. So they get a couple of runs on two hits, no errors, and no one left aboard. We'll see 8, 9, and 1 due up in the bottom of inning number 6. The Twins are in front, 6-3. Jordan Belazovic enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the 6th. So now to the plate, Jacob Stallings. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. All even now, 2-2. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Kepler comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out. Eric Gonzalez will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. There's a swing and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. And this one is gone, a home run. A solo shot here to left, and they cut the gap here. It's now 6-4.
Well, you could see when that one was tracking towards home. That was a hanging breaker right over the middle part of the plate, and that one wasn't coming back.
Into the box, Kevin Newman. Now a swing and a little tapper to the left of the mound. Throw gets him, two down. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Anthony Alford. 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Kepler's on the move, but he won't get there. It falls in.
I don't know how he got to that fastball right there. That looked like the old Tommy Hawk approach back in the 60s and 70s getting to that one.
Blake now, Brian Reynolds. And this one's up around the eyes, 2-1. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Unable to get the bat around in time, and the count evens at 2-2. A runner on first with two away. Throw over to the bag and a dive, but he's back. The 2-2. Swing and a little blooper to center. And that'll get down for a base hit. Lewis Thorpe comes on now, and this move looks to be all about playing the matchup here.
Yeah, and I don't think there's any doubt about that, Matt. They want the lefty-lefty matchup, and that's usually the right move, but we'll just have to see how this plays out.
In now, Colin Moran, line towards center field. Buxton will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. But the Bucks get one back on the solo home run. The 2-3-4 hitters now to start the seventh. It's the Twins 6 and the Buccos 4. Michael Feliz is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7. William Zastadio is up off the bench as he'll pinch hit here to start inning number 7. This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time.
And just when you needed a shutdown inning, a leadoff walk was certainly not on the agenda. He needs a bear down right here.
Now the 3-2 pitch, hit to third. He's right there. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number 7. Alex Kirilloff will come on as a pinch hitter. Hit to first, fielded cleanly, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Nick Gordon will get the call to pinch hit here, as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike 3, and the inning is over. Twins are set down 1-2-3. They're up 6-4. William Zastadio will remain in the game at second base after coming on as a pinch hitter in the last half inning. Alex Kirilloff will stay in the game, taking over in right and batting number 9. Brent Rooker is into the game as well, as he's the new first baseman. Cole Tucker is up off the bench as he'll be asked to get something started in the home half of the 7th. And this is popped up near second base. Simmons waits on it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. number 24, will get a shot here as a pinch hitter. And he lays off, ball four. So he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done.
You know, it takes a lot of discipline to watch a pitch like that go by. But on a 3-1 count, he had the luxury of being a little bit more selective up there. Good take, and a walk is the result.
And that'll bring in Adam Frazier. And Dan, what's the plan of attack here for the guy on the mound?
Well, I think they have to go right after him. He's pretty unlikely to take you deep. But if you allow him to get on base, the chances of him scoring and tying this game become a lot greater.
Runners on first with one down. A ball and two strikes now.
That's exactly the pitch you don't want to be chasing in these situations. He's going to keep that ball down below the hollow of the knee, try and get you to ground into a double play. You have to set your sights at least belt high.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue.
Hey, that fastball caught too much of the plate on an 0-2 count.
Again, he sends it out of play.
He got a mistake right there, but missed it. Can't foul that pitch off in a big spot. 0-2 count. Heater caught too much of the zone.
And he fouls this one off. And it's fouled away. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Buxton is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Alex Colome takes the mound now, and it appears he's being brought in to face the right-handed batter who waits next.
Yeah, you usually don't hear the term righty specialist very often, but that's kind of how they're using him here, Matt. Most hitters have a harder time against pitchers of the same handedness, so we'll see if this move pans out.
Jacob Stallings will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. Two out with the man at first. Two balls and two strikes, the count to the Pirates catcher. Strike three called as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. One left for Pittsburgh. They trail it here 6-4. Cole Tucker will stay in the game, taking over at third base and batting in that nine spot. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Richard Rodriguez will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the eighth spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Michael Perez will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number nine hold in the order here on that double switch. Jared Oliva is into the ballgame as well as he takes over out in right. Jorge Polanco is going to be asked to get things going here as a lead off the top of the eighth. Line drive to left. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. So the Twins put their leadoff hitter on to get the inning started.
Wow, I'm shocked he even pulled the trigger on that pitch. He might have been fooled right there, but he was able to keep his hands back and scramble a good pitch for a base hit.
Kyle Garlick come on to pinch hit now with a runner at first and nobody out. Strike two on a fastball right down the middle. With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-World, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did damage with it. He got the pitch he wanted, and he didn't miss it right there. Hammer job.
To the plate now, Byron Buxton.
Nope.
2-1. Now it looks like a right-hander's up and throwing in the Pittsburgh bullpen. First and second here with nobody out. Fouled away. Fouled off. The 2-2 one more time, and he fouls this one off. The 2-2 one more time. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand, so they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
Standing in now, Mitch Garver. Hit hard on the ground at first, and a backhanded reach at first, but he can't flag it down. And they'll hold that runner at third as everybody moves up a base, and they're loaded with one away. In case you're wondering what remains on the Twins' bench, there it is. We'll see how they want to play things. Travis Blankenhorn will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Reynolds has it, and I'd be surprised if they send the runner. But the throw is well up the line, and he scores easily.
That's a spot right there as a pitcher where you'll trade an out for a run anytime. Bases loaded, and only one run scores on the sacrifice fly.
So now to the plate will be Andrelton Simmons. Couple of singles for him in four trips for him this afternoon. The 2-2. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Long run for the right fielder. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Twins forced to settle for one. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. Twins lead it 7-4. Kyle Garlick will stay in the game, taking over at third base and batting in that eighth spot. Edward Colina is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Number 79 is also into the ball game as he'll assume duties in left field. Bottom of the inning now, and next to hit is the catcher, Michael Perez. Three balls and a strike. Here's the pitch. That's lifted the other way out to left. Left fielder giving chase. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first down. O'Neill Cruz will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. Now the fastball is swung on and missed. Hayes has been a great story in the baseball world lately. This game has taken some major strides since his early days in the minor leagues, and he's had to prove himself time and time again to get to this point.
And he's done exactly that. And I'm sure he's had to prove himself to himself at moments, had to look in the mirror and decide, is this what I want to do with the rest of my life, grinding it out on the buses in the minor leagues? But it all comes to fruition now, stepping into the batter's box in the big leagues for the first time.
That misses, and we're even at 2-2.
Wow, that was a close pitch on 1-2. The count's now on 2-2, but boy, that one very easily could have been called strike three. Really close pitch.
Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2.
You know, you don't always have to straight challenge a guy on a 3-2 count. With the three-run lead, no one on base, this is the perfect situation to do it. No reason to nibble and possibly set up a big inning.
And he lays off ball four, so he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done.
Well, he gives up the walk, but that was a really good pitch. Might have been just out of the zone, but not by much. A lot of guys would have gone fishing for that pitch, so sometimes the hitter just outlasts you.
Digging in once again, Anthony Alford. Last time through was a base hit. Two balls and a strike, here it is. High in the air down the right field line. Long run for the right fielder, and no one will track it down. Working for the punch out and the offering. Runner at first here, one man out. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. He'll try it again, 3-2. Now he gets the ground ball to first. This might be two. Simmons on to first. Not in time, as the umpire was right there to make the call. Ready for another shot now, Brian Reynolds. Now the 1-1 pitch. Bouncer to the left side. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Colin Moran. And with men on base and two away, it feels like this at-bat could go a long way toward deciding this thing.
No doubt, Matt. A base hit here changes this game quite a bit. But if they can't score here, it looks pretty bleak for them heading into the last couple of innings.
A swing and a ball to left field. That's going to get down for a base hit. Alford is on his way home. He will score. And that lead is trimmed to 7-5 here. As he arrives at second without a play, as a run also comes in to score, making it a two-run ball game. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given the chance. And he doesn't try to do too much right here. He just takes what's there. Safely on second.
And we'll have to leave it there, as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Pirates get just the one, and that's all. We've played eight full. It's the Twins 7 and the Pirates 5. O'Neill Cruz will remain in the game in the eighth spot and take over at shortstop. Kyle Crick enters from the pen to start the ninth inning, as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. All set to start the ninth in this one, and that'll bring Williams Astudillo into bat. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch.
Outside, that's a ball.
Yeah. Line to the right side, but a foul ball. Here now the 2-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Into the box now, Alex Kirilloff.
Two balls, one strike.
Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. Shin high fastball that time, ball three.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
And it's fouled away. Now the payoff pitch home. Grounded back up the middle, reined in. And there are two away now. Now at the plate, Brent Rooker, a highly touted prospect in this organization and a former first rounder. He represents the future of his team to many of the fans out there. This is his first major league at bat.
Yeah, what a monster moment for not only himself, but his family, all the coaches that have helped him along the way. This is a monumental moment in his career.
Ready on one and two. Fly ball right down the line and left. Reynolds will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. Down go the Twins in order. They're still up 7-5. Taylor Rogers is the man called on to close this one and earn a save in the ninth. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Jared Oliva. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Number 79 is there, and he makes the catch for the out. Now to the plate, Adam Frazier. His career numbers against this pitcher. He's hitless in three at-bats. Ready with the payoff pitch. And that is swung on and missed, and things are starting to look bleak here for the home nine. There are two away now.
Hey, I'm not sure what he was sitting on right there. I might have been sitting on an off-speed pitch, but instead he gets the fastball way late. Had no chance to put that ball in play.
Castro will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. Swing and a miss, and they're up against it now as they're down to their final strike of the afternoon.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
Hit the other way out toward right field. Kirilloff is there to make the catch, and with that, the ball game is over.
Hey, it's hard to win games at any point, but to win games on the road, especially in this ballpark, so they are very happy with this win.
7-5, how today's comes to an end. Minnesota took the lead in the second inning and rode that until the very end. Kenta Maeda gets the W on the mound. Number 39 worked only three innings in the losing effort. So that's a wrap for us in this one. Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, Matt Vaskersian, we all thank you for watching Major League Baseball on MLB Network. See you next time. Thank you.
I'm over.